Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished heads of states and government, it's a great honor for me to address today the high-level forum for the One Belt, One Road project. A far-reaching 21st century initiative, building on the wisdom of the ancient Chinese concept of the Silk or of the Silk Road. So I want to congratulate China and personally President Xi for his vision and for his warm hospitality in hosting this forum. And I want to underline the great importance that such a vision has, especially in our times. At times when all were facing increasing global and regional challenges in the economic and financial system, in human mobility and migration, in security and regional stability. In these times, when the temptation is great to respond to the crisis of globalization by increasing isolation and by raising walls, this initiative highlights a vision of connectivity, cooperation and dialogue across Europe and Asia, but also other parts of the world. In this context, we believe that it is becoming a crucial vehicle for expanding economic growth, trade and investment. It is crucial for maximizing investment synergies and promoting trade, transport, energy and telecommunication networks through projects that can have a big impact on national economies. On this basis, we will actively support that the initiative pays due attention to strengthening scientific and technological innovation, as well as integrating small and medium-sized enterprises in global value chains. Furthermore, we are convinced that coordination with other regional frameworks such as ASEM, the EU-China Connectivity Platform, or China-Europe Land-Sea Express Route will add value to the initiative. Of course, while always promoting a rules-based, transparent and inclusive international trading system with World Trade Organization at its core. What is particularly positive for us is that the goals of the Belt and Road Initiative are compatible with our own regional economic goals and our dynamic, comprehensive strategic partnership with China sets a solid basis for working in this direction. Greece, after many years of severe crisis, is returning to a growth path which opens up remarkable opportunities for investments and trade. My country is once again taking full advantage of its unique geopolitical identity as a country of Europe, a country of Mediterranean, a country of Balkans and the broader Black Sea region, but also as a maritime country with potential for advancing relations far beyond its neighborhood. In this framework, Greece is expanding its role as an important regional hub in the fields of trade, transport, energy, telecommunications, logistics, culture, and tourism. The Greek people have lived at the crossroads of three continents for thousands of years, trading, working and migrating all over the world. As a country with a rich cultural heritage and a world leader in the tourist industry, we highly value the importance of this initiative for people-to-people contacts, cultural exchanges, and tourism. This year is the Greek-Chinese Cultural Exchange Year. A few weeks ago, we cooperated closely on setting up the first Ministerial Conference of the Ancient Civilizations Forum, while in the field of tourism, direct flights between Greece and China will be starting very soon. As a leading maritime country, looking for new trade routes, we see the great opportunities in the 21st century maritime Silk Road. An increasing number of Greek ship owners build their ships in China, while our biggest port, the port of Piraeus, where a very important investment by Costco has been made, is becoming a global gateway to Europe for products coming from Chinese and other Asian ports, including through the Suez Canal. From Piraeus port, the merchandise can easily be transported by rail to many destinations in the Balkans and in Central Europe. In this spirit, 2015 was the Greek-Chinese Maritime Year. China will be the main guest country in this year in Thessaloniki Trade Festival, while we're working hard on new regional infrastructure projects. Finally, on a diplomatic level, we consider that this multilateral forum sets the ground for important new initiatives. Greece is in any case actively promoting ambitious diplomatic initiatives for cooperation and dialogue on the basis of international law with all the countries of our broader region. And we see important potential for establishing triangular relations around infrastructure projects in the Balkans, but also in the Eastern Mediterranean area. In this framework, I would like to once again thank you for today's very important forum and underline the importance that Greece attaches to the development of the Belt and Road Initiative. Thank you so much.